हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन. स्टूडेंट्स, एज यू नो, वी आर डिस्कसिंग अवर चैप्टर नंबर 4, दैट इज रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द सेक्शुअली ट्रांसमिटेड डिजीज और STDs, डिजीज और इन्फेक्शंस विच आर ट्रांसमिटेड थ्रू सेक्शुअल इंटरकोर्स विद इन्फेक्टेड पर्सन आर कलेक्टिवली कॉल्ड सेक्शुअली ट्रांसमिटेड डिजीज. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, सिफिलीज, एड्स, ट्राइकोमोनासिस एंड फॉर एग्जाम्पल HIV लीडिंग टू एड्स. गोनीरिया बैक्टीरियल डिजीज है, सिफिलीज भी बैक्टीरियल डिजीज है. सो मैनी डिजीज दैट आर कॉज्ड बाई बैक्टीरिया एंड वायरसेज, प्रोटोजो एंड फंजाई, एक्टोपैरासाइट्स एंड नेमेटोड्स, दे आर नोन एज द सेक्शुअली ट्रांसमिटेड डिजीज. नाउ वट इज द मोड ऑफ ट्रांसमिशन ऑफ दीज डिजीज? मोड्स ऑफ ट्रांसमिशन. STDs आर जनरली ट्रांसमिटेड एज ए रिजल्ट ऑफ सेक्शुअल इंटरकोर्स विद इन्फेक्टेड पर्सन, शेयरिंग ऑफ इंजेक्शन नीडल्स, सर्जिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स विद इन्फेक्टेड पर्सन, एंड ट्रांसफ्यूजन ऑफ ब्लड फ्रॉम द इन्फेक्टेड पर्सन एंड फ्रॉम इन्फेक्टेड मदर टू द फीटस. दीज आर द मोड्स ऑफ ट्रांसमिशन ऑफ सेक्शुअली ट्रांसमिटेड डिजीज. नाउ हाउ वी कैन प्रिवेंट? गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया हैज रिसेंटली इनिशिएटेड स्पेशल रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ केयर प्रोग्राम्स to prevent the early occurrence, early detection and cure of STDs. So what are the preventive measures? The preventive measures are: one, must avoid sex with unknown person or multiple persons, always use condom during intercourse. In case of doubt, one must consult a qualified doctor without a delay. Though all persons are vulnerable to these infections, their incidence is very high, but among the adolescents, means in the age group of 15 to 24. Millions of adolescents contract STDs each year. Among these STDs, HIV infection is the most dangerous one. It is spreading among the adolescents because they consider themselves invulnerable and ignore advice to limit their number of sexual partners. Now, next is the topic infertility. What is infertility? All over the world, including India, a large number of couples are infertile. That is, they are unable to produce children in spite of unprotected sex. Such a phenomenon is termed as the infertility. What could be the reasons? There are so many reasons. Infertility may be in males and in females. These can be categorized as physical, congenital, disease, drugs, immunological and physiological. Either male or a female or both partners can suffer from infertility disorders. The infertility disorders can be diagnosed by specialist doctor or healthcare units. For example, infertility clinics. Some of these infertility disorders can be cured through corrective treatment under the supervision of specialists and enable the infertile couple to have children. But however, there are some disorders where such corrective treatment is not possible. In that case, couples are assisted to have children through certain special techniques. And what are the techniques? The techniques are known as assisted reproduction technologies or ART. First is test tube baby. What is test tube baby? Test tube baby, in this method, the fertilization occurs in vitro. In vitro means outside the body in a special culture medium. In some women, normal conception is not possible because of the oviducts may be blocked or some acidic secretions in the vagina that do not allow the fertilization or low sperm count of the husband. These are also cases where in women cannot produce ova or men cannot produce sperm. In all such cases, ovum from the wife donor is removed surgically after hormonal stimulation. It is then fertilized by her husband's or donor's male sperm in a laboratory dish containing a nutrient medium. And then zygote or early embryo up to 8 stage blastomeres is transferred into the fallopian tube of that female. Theek hai ji, what is the success rate of test tube babies in our country? The success rate of this technique of producing test tube babies is less than 20%. To increase the chance of success, the prospective mother is given fertility drugs which cause many ovarian follicles to mature at the same time. This releases many eggs simultaneously, thereby increasing the chances of the success. The additional embryos are transferred to the surrogate mothers for completion of the development. They can be frozen for later use. Numerous children can be produced by in vitro fertilization without any abnormality. Now, what is a surrogate mother? Surrogate mother is that female whose uterus is very healthy and she can help in the growth of the embryo. For example, a female whose uterus is not working properly, but she is able to produce the ova and her husband is also fertile, having good sperm count or motile sperm, and the zygote of that couple is transferred into the surrogate mother and the surrogate mother give birth to their children. But there are so many problems in our society that are raised against the test tube babies. The production of test tube babies involving the surrogate mother and the surrogate mother raises ethical and legal problems, such as she said about the right over the child. In the case experimental woman supplies more than one egg, the extract will go waste or will have to be implanted in the surrogate mother's. The eggs of the woman may be got fertilized with the sperm of a donor who is not the husband. These are the legal problems that are created during test tube babies. Now next is the GIFT or gamete intrafallopian transfer. This method is used in females who cannot produce ova but can provide suitable environment for fertilization and further development of the embryo in the oviduct. In such cases, ovum from the donor female is surgically removed and induced in the fallopian tube of such female. Such woman then accepts sperms from her husband during copulation or natural method. Next is ICSI, intracytoplasmic sperm injection. Intracytoplasmic sperm injection is another specialized technique to form an embryo in the laboratory in which sperm is directly injected into the ovum placed in the nutrient medium. The zygote is transferred by surgical method in the uterus of the female. Next is artificial insemination technique. This technique is used in those females where the husband either is unable to inseminate or has low sperm count. In such cases, the sperm of the husband or donor is first collected and artificially introduced into the vagina or in the uterus of the female. Students, all these methods or techniques, they require extremely high precision handling by specialized professionals and expensive instrumentation. Such facilities are presently available only in few centers in our country and are available to a limited number of people. But emotional, religious and social factors provide hurdles in the adoption of these methods in our country. Next is amniocentesis. Amniocentesis. What is amniocentesis? Transabdominal aspiration of fluid from amniotic sac of the fetus. Why this fluid is used? This fluid is used to diagnose the genetic disorders, if any, in the embryo, or used to know about the sex of the child. But today this is misused. This is misused in our country for killing the normal female fetus. Some way out to end this malpractice must be found. Understanding of equality of sexes can help in this manner. Determination of sex by this method has been banned. Now, instead of this amniocentesis, chronic villus sampling is discovered. This is a technique for drying out the fetal cells, same for checking out the genetic disorders. How this technique is performed? This technique is formed without injuring the fetus with the needle only after the 16th week of the pregnancy. At this time, abortion is not safe. A new technique, chronic villus sampling is used. It can be done during the 8th to the 10th week of pregnancy when abortion is safe for the woman. अमाइनोसेंटोसिस 16th वीक में होता था जहाँ पे अबॉर्शन सेफ नहीं है. क्रॉनिक विल्लाई सैम्पलिंग ये 8 to 10th वीक में हो जाता है. अगर कोई जेनेटिक डिसऑर्डर होता भी है तो यहाँ पे अबॉर्शन पॉसिबल है. फॉर CVS यानी कि क्रॉनिक विल्लाई सैम्पलिंग, द डॉक्टर इंसर्ट्स ए नैरो फ्लेक्सिबल ट्यूब और दैट इज नोन एज कैथेटर. कैथेटर इंसर्ट इन टू द यूट्रस थ्रू द मदर्स वजाइना guided by the ultrasound and sucks small amount of fetal tissue. The cells of the chronic villi are then used for karyotyping. What is karyotyping? Karyotyping is study of human chromosomes for knowing the genetic disorders. Result of karyotyping and some biochemical tests are performed on these cells and can be and the reports can be obtained within a few hours. CVS technique provides a mass of rapidly dividing fetal cells, thus facilitating the examination of genetic disorders. Now, what are the advantages of CVS over amniocentesis? Number one, it is less time consuming. It can be performed early, 8 to 10th week. And now, next is non-invasive technique. What are non-invasive techniques? Non-invasive techniques are those techniques that are available to determine the fetal conditions. One of these is ultrasounding imaging. This is known as fetoscopy. What is fetoscopy? Fetoscopy is a technique which is used by the doctor to have a direct view of the fetus. A needle, thin tube containing a viewing scope is inserted through vagina and cervix into the uterus to directly view the fetus. This is known as fetoscopy. It is also known as the ultrasound. Students, with this our chapter number 4, that is reproductive health, is over. Thank you and have a nice day.